Good afternoon, I'm Councilman Ari Kagan, representing 47th District of Southern Brooklyn. Right now it's beautiful weather, great day. We are in Kaiser Park in Coney Island. Today is a family day. A lot of kids, a lot of parents, everybody enjoying this event. It's games, snacks, rolling skating, face painting. Everybody enjoying every possible activities here. My office is sponsoring this event together with Department of Parks. And we welcome everyone, of course, Coney Island residents and everyone in Southern Brooklyn, always welcome to attend. Tomorrow will be Father's Day. I congratulate every father. It's so important that fathers take care of their children. Congratulations to our great fathers. Also, June is the month of graduation, school graduations. I love to attend these graduations to greet parents, children, students, teachers, principals. I always say the children do not grow like mushrooms. It's a very hard work by everybody, by parents, by teachers. So it's so important that we took care of our children. I'm very proud of father of two beautiful children who already graduated from schools here in Southern Brooklyn. Also, a few words about what's going on in City Hall. We voted for several important legislation and at the last stated council meeting. I voted for creation of Office of Healthcare Accountability because I strongly believe that we need a website, public information, transparency about how our public hospitals and private hospitals, actually, everybody using public taxpayers' money or using Medicare, Medicaid, health insurance. So we need to know what are the healthcare rates. If someone receiving a bill from the hospital, thousands and thousands of dollars, I believe we have a right to know what they're charging us for. So I believe it will be very good when everybody will know on the website, public information, what kind of procedures are in every hospital and how much does it cost. It will help to bring transparency and also it will bring down costs because not every hospital wants you to know that they're charging for the same procedure three times more than neighboring hospital. So it will be very helpful to save taxpayers' money. That's why I voted for it, to create Office of Healthcare Accountability. But I also voted against several bills. In particular, I voted against one proposal by New York State Legislature to give New York City an authority to impose several taxes. Income tax, city income tax, and taxes on several small businesses, like beauty salons, like gyms. And I specifically asked Finance Division of New York City Council, what will happen if not just myself, not just Republicans, but everybody will vote against it? What is going to happen with our taxes? Guess what was the answer? Oh no, if you vote against it, then our income tax of the city of New York, personal income tax, would not be any more 10%. It would be 6.5%. Oh my gosh, it's a nightmare. Our taxes will go down. Not up, will go down, and on small businesses will go down. But that's fantastic, that's exactly what we need to do. We need to cut taxes, we need to help people to survive during the high inflation and rising cost of everything. Instead, we're doing completely opposite. My Democratic colleagues in City Hall voting every 2 weeks another tax, another fee, another toll. You know, this year will be increased public transportation fares 5%, tolls 5% increase, congestion pricing up to $23 to enter Manhattan, will be more expensive cans of soda instead of 5 cents per can will be 10 cents. Also, planning other increases. Why do we need to increase taxes all the time? How does it help New Yorkers? I don't understand. I voted against it. And another legislation, idea was good, but when you read fine print, it's a terrible idea. The initial idea was to vote for housing vouchers for people with low income. Beautiful idea. How can I not support subsidized housing, vouchers for people with low income, so they would be able not to become homeless? But then when you read the fine print, it's not so cool. First of all these lines for people who are homeless people, for people who live in the conditions when their ceiling will be falling down on them, emergency conditions. And only third line was for everybody else. Everything, all of these lines are no longer be in existence. Everybody will be on the same line, including 70,000 migrants who obviously don't have any income. They're also added to these rolls. So everyone, I emphasize, everyone who cannot pay for 1 or 2 months rent will be eligible for these vouchers regardless of their status. Which means people who really need vouchers, who really need housing vouchers, will not be able to get them, including homeless New Yorkers. So how does it help anybody? On top of this, the price tag of this proposal already $17 billion. $17 billion. And right now, city of New York barely making it, you know, break even. So how are we going to pay for it? Oh, I know how we're going to pay. Very soon you will hear it in September and October, another proposal to raise another tax. Because it's impossible. Where we're going to get this $17 billion? But who is asking? By the end of the day, again, I'm a big supporter of housing vouchers, but I voted against this proposal because it's a wrong proposal. It punishes homeless New Yorkers. It punishes people who are paying rent, because it encourages people not to pay rent, to receive eviction notice and to apply for the vouchers right away. So that's not how it goes. Again, it should be only to people who really, really need our help. And also, income level up to $60,000 a year for a family of three. So again, in my opinion, it just encourages fraud, housing fraud in this case. And why do we have in all of these subsidized NYCHA buildings so many vacant apartments? Why not to fix all of these vacant apartments and to give it to people of New York City? 270,000 people are waiting on a line for NYCHA apartments. 270,000 people. And we have vacancies in every apartment building in NYCHA. Why? That should be the priority, in my opinion. But nobody is talking about it. So that's why sometimes I feel very frustrated. But I'm going to oppose bills that I strongly disagree with, and I will speak out. Nobody will tell me, don't talk anymore, stop talking. This is America, this is New York. I can speak out, and you know, like, I will express myself no matter what. Thank you so much. I'm Councilman Ari Kagan, and have a beautiful day. Thank you.